Oh, you've really spoilt those lemurs rotten. Now, I think it's time we looked at one of the zoo's most important responsibilities, releasing animals into the wild. You see, when we feel an animal is ready, we can release them into the wild. But what makes an animal a good candidate for release? Well, their age is an important factor. I mean, we can't release an animal that's a juvenile, just as we can't release one that's gotten too old. They'll also need to be fertile. After all, the idea is to repopulate the wild, so the best candidates will have a high fertility gene. And together, the age and fertility of a candidate will determine how many conservation credits we'll be rewarded when we release them. Now, conservation credits are vitally important. They're the lifeblood of your zoo, because earning them allows you to adopt even more animals. And what's more, the animals you can adopt will be of a higher quality. So, with that in mind, let's pop over to our orangutan habitat. Okay, I'd like you to find Ageng, the Bornean orangutan in the habitat, and select him, please. You can either click through each orangutan in turn, or select the habitat barrier, go to the Animals tab in the Habitat Information panel, and find him in the Animals list. I know it's sad to see him go, but he'll be happy out in the wild. And he's a wonderful candidate for release. Young, strong, and fertile. Excellent work there. You've definitely got potential, you know.
Ah, I see you've been doing some homework. Although, it hardly seems like work when you're learning about something as adorable as a ring-tailed lemur. I imagine I'd have got much better grades at school if there'd been less algebra and more aldebra. Tortoises.
Okay, so far we've done a lot of work with habitat animals, but now it's time to learn all about exhibit animals. Let's build a brand new exhibit. I've marked an area for our new exhibit. How about we head over there? Lovely. Now let's build a new exhibit in the gap that's been left. Just add it to the building like we did with the research centre earlier, then pop it into the gap. Perfect. The next thing to do is adopt an exhibit animal to go in there. How about a Gila monster? Open up the exhibit trading section and adopt one. Just as we do with habitat animals, we need to send the Gila monster to the exhibit. Click on the exhibit to send it there. When you send an animal to an exhibit, it'll automatically be given the correct setup. But that doesn't mean it's completely ready for them. So let's finish it off. We'll start by adding some enrichment items. Click on the exhibit to bring up its information panel. Good. Now click on the layout tab. Oh, well, it looks like we've only got the enrichment level 1 items unlocked at the moment. Never mind. Let's turn on at least one of them for the Gila monster. As I'm sure you know by now, you can unlock more enrichment levels by having one of your vets do some research. Now, we'll also need to set the temperature and humidity in the exhibit. These are vitally important for keeping our Gila monster happy and comfortable. Click on the Climate tab. Here, you can see the Gila monster's desired temperature and humidity. You can change both of these by adjusting the dials below. Make sure it's going to be nice and cozy. The ticket? And the last thing we need to look at is setting up the different windows. So click on the Windows tab. You can edit and customize any of the windows on an exhibit. A window can be closed and blank, or have a two-dimensional background, or even a three-dimensional background on it. Why don't you have a play around with the options? There's also an exhibit education board. Pop them down near your exhibits to teach your guests about them. Let's add one now. Lovely stuff. Now our guests can learn all about our venomous friend here. Right, now, I've got a bit of a big job for you. I need you to increase the number of species in the zoo. You'll probably want to adopt both habitat and exhibit animals to do so, which will mean building plenty of new habitats and exhibits for them. Go on, off you pop. I'll check in with you when you're almost done.
Memona and Teleza can know we can do and Teleza Botella and almost need to one for Matilly Paris Exploration Banari.
Yes. they say?
Yeah.
Mr. Neil, my people, Shannon, say Sheila Edgar.